Hi, welcome to Tech Tips with Sold Out Media.
I'm Linus.
I'm Amanda. Today, we wanted to compare with you two seemingly similar microphones and similar price points. This is the NTG5.
This is the Deity V-Mic D3
right?
Pro.
They both have this producer's pack or location pack. Handle, the dead cat, the windsock, the big fluffy windsock, and all the fixins for being out and recording. Mm. But then we were talking with our producers and we thought, I mean, price-wise, this is a really good comparison, but we happen to have an NTG3 as well. And so the difference with the NTG3 is you pay about $200 more for it, and you don't get any of those
fancy
extra
stuff.
No, none of the windsocks or anything like that. You do get a standard windsock, but you don't get the big fluffy one or the handle or any of that. So then we said, okay, well, let's see actually how close it is to them. Is it worth getting the NTG3 for a little bit more without anything compared to these? But then we said, we have all these other microphones too. So we have a Sennheiser MKH60, and we have a 66 as well. And then we have an AKG C568EB, which you actually can't buy anymore. But we thought, well, how do these guys stack up?
Do they?
Right. Then on price point, the AKG, when you could buy them, was about $600 US. The Sennheiser MKH60 is actually the most expensive out of all the microphones on the table. It's $1,500 US. The ME66 is $160, but really that's just for the top half of it. The Deity comes in at about $200.
Mm-hmm.
The NTG5 is about $500. But we're in Sweden, so these two actually came out to be a lot more similar. I think I paid 5,000 crowns for him and 4,000 crowns for him here in Sweden. It's not fair. Don't ask us why. Things are just different here.
Taxes, man.
We do ship things in from the US quite often. So anyway, price-wise, we thought that there's definitely some categories that we could try. Let's do that. Let's jump ahead. You can listen to the audio tests, and then we'll come back and tell you what we found.
Yeah.
We're now outside to test and compare different shotgun mics.
And for this test, we are using a Zoom H6 handy recorder with the gain set at 8. So we want to hear how the different frequency responses of these mics affect how we hear the recorded sound, at the same time that we hear how it captures the voice compared to unwanted sounds from the background, and how it performs with noise caused by the wind. This is at 1 meter away from the mic.
So now we have the Deity V-Mic D3 Pro.
The Rode NTG3, Rode NTG5, Sennheiser ME66, Sennheiser MKH60, AKG C568 at 3 meters away.
We are recording with a Zoom H6 handy recorder
with the gain set at 9. We want to hear how much difference we have compared to other distances, and how the proximity affects the recorded audio.
Coming back from that, what did you hear?
A lot.
A lot, right? Yeah. There's a lot of similarities across the board with all the microphones. Of course, shotgun microphones have a unique sound. But I think that overall, the NTG3 has more high-end and more noise rejection. It is a very clean microphone. In fact, it's praised as the best for broadcast. TV people love the NTG3. I think that if you're a professional videographer, it's something that you should definitely have in your box. But compared to the NTG5, there's very little difference. The only big difference in the NTG5 to the NTG3 is that it has a little less high-end sound to it. So, I mean, side by side, it's very hard to tell the difference between that microphone and that microphone. Mm-hmm. So in conclusion, if you're talking about NTG5 versus NTG3, if your main business is good sound, NTG3 all day.
Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely.
And you spend the extra money to get the extra grip and dead cat, as they call it. But I mean, if you're just a beginner filmmaker, or even like a moderate level filmmaker, The NTG5 is great too, and you can hardly tell the difference between the NTG5 and the NTG3. The biggest differences are going to end up when you're really doing sound recording as your main business.
Yeah.
What did you think about the Rode NTG5 versus the Deity?
I think the NTG5 wins because the D3 has more mid-range, or it makes it a little muddy, but otherwise it's good. It has a little bit more background noise as well, but yeah, I really like the sound the NTG5 does.
Right, and what about the Sennheiser mics?
Well, both the Sennheiser mics, they sound very similar. Obviously, this guy had a little bit more oomph, a little better noise sound all together, but...
Sounded a little more natural.
Yeah, so what do you think? Why is that one so much more expensive?
I cannot understand why you spend so much more money for him over these guys.
No.
And to be honest, it's not even the top-ranking Sennheiser microphone. I think it's the 416 that people recommend.
I think so.
Don't quote me on that, I haven't looked, but our audio technician also told us that these Sennheiser microphones, they really started to shine at 3 meters, so they weren't really great right up close.
No.
So yeah, both the NTG5 and the NTG3, they have a better pickup when they're closer to you.
Yeah.
The AKG actually had a little bit more of an issue. It is an older microphone, and it does seem to have some break in the connection, so it was very hard to test. But when we held the XLR just the right way, we did find that it had an excellent sound to it.
Yeah, it did sound good,
It sounded excellent. But it's hard to say what the noise floor was on it. It was very noisy, but that could have been part of the connection.
Yeah, I think so.
But it also could have been part of the fact that out of all of the microphones, it had the highest impedance. So just to go through them, the NTG3, 25 ohms, the 5, 25 ohms, the Deity, 200 ohms, the Sennheiser, 60, 150 ohms, the 66, 200 ohms, the AKG, 600 ohms impedance, which meant the gain had to go way up to the top.
Yeah, well, that'll do it.
That'll do it. And, and if you do any audio, if you have to gain up, you're always going to get extra noise, right? So in conclusion, NTG3 is the winner. The NTG5 comes in second. The Sennheisers take third and fourth place. Third being the MKH60, fourth being the ME66.
Yeah.
The AKG could take fifth place because of the clean sound that you get from it.
But since we don't really
we can't really test it, that means the Deity takes fifth place.
Yep.
Right? So there you have it. Again, you can get great quality without having to pay super much money.
Yeah.
But all of these are good options.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So I hope this was helpful to you.
Hope you had fun watching.
Right.
We had fun making it.
Right. Thank you so much. Have a great day.
Yeah.